Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Logan with West Desert Wheeler, and today we are out here in the beautiful Sand Hollow. I am currently standing on actually a split of two real rock crawling trails. So behind me, you can go up Chain Reaction, or you can go up Broken Chain. We're out here ready to go hit some nasty terrain on Chain Reaction and Broken Chain.
The last time I was in here, I had my four-wheel steer Capra, and that was back when it was on 1.9-inch BFG crawlers. And I don't really remember being a boulder field like this before this next obstacle. So I'm gonna see if we can kind of navigate these rocks and try and work our way towards this next big ledge climb. This is admittedly like where I'm not the greatest, is on loose boulders like this where the tires can get eaten up by the holes and whatnot. Just like that, kind of making bad decisions here. So let's see if we can take the high line up and around. Now what's funny is there's probably people who practice nothing but this and they're laughing at how terrible I am at this. So if you guys have a bunch of terrain where it's just loose boulders and you're really good at it, let me know. Just move that one out of our way. Maybe we can drop the rear down right there. All right, so now we're kind of squared up, ready to take on the next climb. We're gonna stay high on the right side with the fronts to try and get them worked just around this overhang that I'm now driving into. Wiggle your servos, it breaks the tension a little bit. There we go. Now, the rear is going to try and fall into the hole, so you got to watch that. Let's get it far enough left where we kind of just go right over it and bring it on back. Dang, these swampers are getting really good traction. They are the G8 compound. These are the 2.2-inch swampers, but they are not the XLs, so they're 5.4 height, 5.35, somewhere in there. And I really like the proportions of these on this truck. They are big tires, but with a long wheelbase and the four-wheel steer, I think it puts great use to them. So here we go, we'll get our truck worked uphill, swing it down, maybe take a little bit of a reset there. And then we'll try and transverse this crack. As you come up the other side, it looks like there's some cool ledges and rocks. Got the portal clearance going on. This thing has a ton of clearance between the ground and the portals. So got to keep our nose off the rocks. There we go. Straddling both sides here at the moment. I'm actually on my diff and steering links in the rear. It's kind of hard to pull off, really. There we go. Now I'm gonna kind of crab, straighten up the rear, hunting for the traction, crab driver, and then turn. Brought it right around that ledge on the bottom right. I don't wanna lose this back left. Yeah, a lot of tire work and wiggling there, but it got it done. That was cool. Go ahead and bring it down. Nice and easy, this sensored brushless system, super smooth, lifted tire, got it done. This is a great spot for RC crawling. Got lots of fun obstacles in this really tightly packed area. A lot of good challenges. We're gonna try and get up this double ledge here. Right as that back comes up, the next one goes up. So pretty dang cool. Work the rear around. I'm gonna turn the fronts back towards me, get that rear tire up, and then crab all uphill, and it pulls the truck right up. Here we are, yet another obstacle that I have not done before. But this one looks like a real challenge and it should be pretty fun. I think I'm gonna try and exit up the right side if possible, but that looks real tough, so we're gonna see what's possible. Here we are, working our front end up.
is steep. I don't even know if we're gonna get past this first ledge here, guys. You get the front end kind of worked down like that. A little less on the rear. This truck is like straight up right now, but it's got a pretty good hook. Just need to drop that front right off the wall. There we go. Kind of drop it in there. Work that rear hard into that wall. So our issue here is that the front right tire is so squared up to that wall that when it touches, it pulls the truck backwards. So like when I try and turn into the wall for traction, it pulls the whole truck backwards off the wall. So kind of gonna have to turn up this a little more forward. So I'm just trying to like balance it where it's close to the wall, but not quite on it. It's surprisingly further than I anticipated once I pulled up on it. Luckily these big 2.2s are like pillows and they can really load up, like that front left tire can really load up with some tension and give the truck some serious bite. I so rarely do this, guys. I just put some rocks down. Let's see if I can get some more bite out of the rear by having that little rock in there. The rear tire may actually be higher on that wall than that rock is when it's not making it. So we'll see what happens. There we go. Trying to keep that front right low. I also need to like get up in these rocks first. There she goes. If it just had a little skinnier belly pan, it might work. Oh wow. We're staying on the wall. And it looks like it wants it. Now we're contending with this rock up on our front left. It's just grazing past that front left rock. That rock's pretty small. It'll probably move. Don't you lose it. Oh. Come on, truck. It's pushing it up on top of that ledge. Okay. Oh man, it's so close. Pretty wild climb we got going. We're on the top edge of that front tire. There we go, backing up. And then move our rear and go forward. I don't really know what to do here because this truck's in a really wild position. All I know is I can't go too crazy because I don't want it to fall off of the formation. This is the craziest line I've ever done. This is insane. Nothing makes sense right now. Oh, so close. Really interesting. I crab crawled and it pulled it up out of there. Okay. So let's get a better view of what's going on. Let's set that front left down on top of this canyon and straddle this part. There we go. Got the truck balanced back out. I'm gonna try and squeeze that rear tire on the inside of that rock, then turn back into it just like that. Probably should have stayed balanced on the front. Yeah, let's actually take a back up here. There we go. Really delicate backing up when you're balanced like this, especially on an obstacle this wild.
truck's binding. A little too much traction on those rear tires. Might have to kind of take a reset here. Our rear tire is real trapped now, and our front tire. We're in serious trouble. All right, guys, crawled our way back up to this point just to try and save some screen time, honestly. Ah, man. Here we go with this again. Truck is not happy. Front tire is trapped under a rock. Servos are really fighting here. Just a little bit of motor movement can really save your servos there. It is moving that whole rock. Brushless power, come on. Tires trapped in there. Oh, it gets so close. I would say that this is absolutely on par with what the actual trail here is. On broken chain. Okay, looks like that's what I needed to do. Give it a little more straight push in the rear. Front end's gonna come up. Now we can start to turn out of it, I think. That was a hell of a fight. These servos are not happy, and I'm sure about that. Okay, get the rear tire on the rock. Keep the front balance this time. Don't let it fall off. Left rear rock has completely moved from where it originally was. No surprise. Losing it. Crab along. Starting to turn out. Gonna use that front left rock up here in the crack. Turn the rear into it. Okay. Losing the buggy, guys. Oh, I'm so close. Not quite sure what to do here. Here we go, uprighted it. Wow, that was wild. No, suspension unloaded on me. Damn. Come on. We're about to completely lose this. Well, we're officially upside down. Don't think we're gonna save it. Here we are on the upper part of Broken Chain, and I just wanna kinda highlight like how cool this spot is. So you've got this big wedge shape obstacle, and you're gonna be climbing up a vertical wall on the left, vertical wall on the right, and then you gotta bring your front end up, and then you go and chase it through this canyon. So nothing real crazy to rock crawl through here for my RC truck, but just a super awesome obstacle for the real buggies. You're gonna be straddling this whole length of this canyon before you get out to the end here, and then turn out to the right. So super awesome.
Like I say, nothing real challenging for my truck because it's only a foot and a half wide, but right here, you're gonna have about 5 feet of air under your buggy, 6 feet. Super cool. Definitely an awesome part on broken chain. There we go, had a little bit of a vertical climb on my RC truck. And then right here, a little bit of an overhang on that left side, bring that tire up, and then just turn it on through. Pretty cool. Just having a real good time here on my side, trying to get this rear tire through this crack. All right, well, it never went up the wall, that's all right. Yeah, this isn't really for RCs, but you know what? We tried it, it was fun, whatever. Maybe an MOA car, like, they really might be able to. It's pretty damn steep though. And sometimes you just can't get over how steep some obstacles are. Perfect fit for the width of my truck through there. And we're on to the next wall. Just set the truck up top for fun. See if we can get through this little gap up here. This right here is probably what the real trucks look like as they come through here. Just barely balanced on each side of the wall, bunch of air under the truck. Super cool looking obstacles. These are my absolute favorites. Here we are on the front side. Just balancing here. That's why I did the bottom of chain reaction and the top of broken chain. The obstacles there are just awesome for these trucks. So I'm standing down in a wedge that's super, super narrow. This truck was actually just not quite able to pull it off because of how narrow it was. And I'm gonna see if I can kind of get this thing to transverse across this crack. Coming down that steep of a wall, sometimes you can't get the turning that you're looking for, even with four-wheel steer. Might have to take one more reset here. Crab uphill. And then get lined up as we drop back down in. Okay, well, I'm trying to do the balance act here. So we set down our rear, got the front across. What if we just crabbed three tires through here? That'd be kind of cool, honestly. Trying to get that rear tire to grab and push on that wall. This is a pretty wild one. I've never done anything quite like this. We're about to lose our front end. Ah, we lost it. Well, guys, it's been a hell of a ride. Been having a ton of fun out here on broken chain and chain reaction. Definitely two super cool trails out here in Sand Hollow State Park. I think it's about time to close this one out. Got a ton of video. Hopefully my SD card's still good because my GoPro got super hot and started acting weird. Again, working our way through a balancing act. Hope you guys didn't get burned out on those. If you've watched all the way till the end, I really do appreciate it. Thank you guys very much. The RC community here on YouTube has been super awesome, super nice. I really enjoyed all the comments and hope you guys are enjoying the content. So thank you very much for watching. Please get subscribed. There are affiliate links to build a truck like this down in the comments section, and hope you guys enjoyed it. Big shout out to Rock Pirates RC. They offer awesome element and axial parts. That's the shock towers in the rear that I'm using, as well as a battery tray in this truck. They are from Rock Pirates RC. Also want to send a shout out to my friend over at Axial. Really appreciate all the support he's given me through the past couple months. Thanks again for watching. I greatly appreciate it.
get subscribed if you're not already, and keep the rubber side down.